Okay.
First question, Hogan, if we can. Do you understand why the president could not possibly be a victim of a lynching?
I'm sorry?
Do you understand why the president couldn't possibly be the victim of a lynching?
Yeah, but the president's not comparing what happened to him with one of our darkest moments in American history.
He's just not.
What he's explaining clearly is the way he's been treated by the media since he announced for president. The word impeachment.
The word impeachment was used about this president the day he was elected
and before he was even sworn into office. Let's not talk about that. And I understand that there are many people in the media who don't agree with his language. But he has used many words to describe the way he has been relentlessly attacked, and 93% of the news coverage against him is negative. Let's talk about what the president's actually done for the African American community. Yes.
You know the history of that word.
Yes.
You condemn lynchings.
Again, the president was clearly articulating the way he feels about the way you guys have been treating him from day one. If you want to talk about what the president has actually done for the African American community, I'd love to have that conversation because there are many things he has done. Impeachment in this particular instance, he is receiving no due process, as many of you know. Every single one of your reports start with behind closed doors, comma. He is not receiving due process. We all are aware of the situation in which Democrats are taking him behind closed doors, releasing selective things, not in context, trying to attack and destroy this president. The fact is he has been relentlessly attacked by the mainstream media since before he took office. That's what the president's talking about here.
Can you understand why every African American in this country is furious right now?
What the president has done for the African American community is something no other president has been able to accomplish in my lifetime. People are upset about President Trump's words all of the time. But what you can't argue with are the results he's put forth for the African American community, whether we're talking about opportunity zones in inner cities, whether we're talking about criminal justice reform, which is something Barack Obama wanted forever, that Democrats clamored for, but only Donald Trump was able to deliver, and the fact that his economic policies have resulted in record low unemployment in African American communities as well.
Hogan, I'm sorry. With respect, you're glossing over the fact.
I have answered this question now multiple times. If you guys want to talk about something else, I'm happy.
New level of outrage, Hogan. You can't rely. You can't respect that.
Putin and Erdogan and the notion that Russia is moving into the vacuum that the U.S. is leaving.
Repeat the first part. I'm sorry.
Comment on the meeting between Putin and Erdogan and the notion that Russia is filling in the vacuum that the U.S. is leaving.
Well, that's what we're trying to avoid. The president went into these national security issues wide-eyed, and now you see even some who were his detractors, like Lindsey Graham, for example, now coming out saying it's optimistic, because the president was clear when he ran for president. What he wanted to do was secure those regions, finish the missions, and bring our troops home. That's exactly what he's trying to do. He still wants to keep forces behind to protect the oil, to ensure stability in the region, and today is the final day of the ceasefire. We expect that temporary ceasefire, that temporary de-escalation, to transition into permanent by the end of the afternoon. And the president takes this very seriously, as you all know, because he sent a delegation headed up by the Vice President of the United States to secure a historic deal between two warring sides for hundreds of years. They came back with that deal, and we're monitoring it very closely because we do want peace and stability in the region, and we want to maintain the gains we've had. He's the one who defeated ISIS, the caliphate, 100%, and we want to make sure they don't reconstitute.
Are you saying that black Americans who are upset should suck it up because the economy's good?
Go ahead.
Are you saying black Americans, I'm sorry, Hogan, should you? Are you saying black Americans should suck it up because the economy's
good? Go right ahead.
All right, back on the tweet. If, why doesn't the president tweet about the economy, about his accomplishments? Why does he keep going back to racial animus?
I don't understand in what way.
Yep. Why is he including that in his tweet? He does it intentionally. He does it repeatedly. He goes back to these dark times in our history. Why?
He's not comparing himself to those dark. He's not comparing himself to those dark times. Let's be very clear about what he's doing. He is receiving zero due process from Democrats on the Hill. That's what he's talking about. It's very clear.
And you guys can,
it is very clear. You understand as well as I do that whether it was Nixon or whether it was Clinton, Everyone was given due process in this situation, but they refused to give it to Donald Trump.
Would you,
now,
Hogan,
are we going to talk about something else, or are we going to continue with the tweet?
Can I ask you about Syria,
please?
In regards to Syria, he has said repeatedly that he's bringing troops home, yet they aren't home. Is he bringing them home soon? And just a follow-up, would you choose that word? Would you?
First question first. The president does want to ultimately bring all of these troops home. That was his goal when he ran for office. That's what he wants to do now. But he also wants to ensure stability in the region. He wants the de-escalation to stay where it is now. The ceasefire is working. We're hoping it becomes permanent. But the fact is, you have to keep some people over there. He understands that. He's running this. He's making these decisions. He's the one that has the responsibility, and it is a heavy one, to protect American citizens overseas, to protect our assets, our friends, our partners and allies, and the American people, and that's what he's doing. I'm sorry.
Can you just call out by answering that?
Has the White House anything to do?
I did.
Has the White House anything to do, anything to say about the electoral fraud allegations on Bolivia's president?
Continue? On Bolivia's president?
Yeah, the electoral fraud allegations against Bolivia's president, Evo Morales.
I've not seen the allegations, but I'm happy to look into it and get back to you on it. I'm sorry?
Why does the president feel that Republicans aren't unified? He complained about it yesterday.
Why does he feel they're not unified? Well, look, I think it's pretty obvious when the Democrats have done what they've been able to do, which is run a sham impeachment on this president. They've attacked him from day one. If his name was President Smith, they'd be giving him all the credit in the world. And there are plenty of Republicans who feel a lot of pressure. But the fact is, the Democrats are in the wrong here, and Republicans are on the best ground. And the ground is a fake, phony, false impeachment hearing. But all. Well, look, President Trump's a fighter, and he fights back when he's attacked, especially in this instance when he's attacked even in the midst of all these successes, and he thinks everyone should fight back. It's a time to stand tough and stand against the lack of due process. It's time to stand up for all the successes that we've seen in this administration. It's time to stand against the ridiculous and foolhardy ideas of the Democrat Party that's only going to take us backwards. And that's what he's talking about when he wants people to move forward.
Are you saying black Americans should just deal with it because the economy is good?
Should the president not have used it? Do you disagree with Senator Scott?
What did Senator Scott say?
The president should not have used that word.
Oh, but look, Senator Graham said it was a perfect word. The fact is, many people disagree. And he's one of my friends. I've known him now for over a decade.
But he said it's not a good choice of word. Do you agree it's not a good choice of
word? But people disagree with what President Trump says all the time. I would urge people to focus on what he's accomplished for the American people.
You don't think this everything is a new
he
level?
Everything he says gets scrutinized and picked apart by both sides. But the fact is, the accomplishments he's had for the American people, whether it's African American unemployment, Asian American unemployment, Hispanic American unemployment, whether you're white, black, brown, red, it doesn't matter. His policies have lifted all the boats in this country, and that is the story.
Okay.
Thank you, everybody.
Does a good economy mean he